Essential NLP. Practical skills for a great life.
Hi, and a very warm welcome from me, your host, Phil Parker, to Essential Skills of NLP. Podcast number 27. And today I'm going to tell you a little bit what I've been up to this week, and then we're going to move on to de-stressing. So what have I been doing this week? Well, mainly I've been lying in bed feeling ill with a sore throat and a high fever. And I thought I'd share that just because in terms of NLP, what do you do with that? Well, first thing is you look at it and think, well, that's a shame. And then you think, is there anything I could learn from this? Can I see this differently? And the first thing I get from it is how great it is to be well, because we just don't notice when we're well. We kind of only notice wellness when we're ill and wish we notice we don't have it anymore. And the second thing is I work a lot with people who are ill and generally help them to recover. And being ill yourself is a real wake-up call to exactly how dreadful it is to feel ill all the time. And the further we get away from being ill, the more we just forget it and it disappears into the background. So it's kind of a useful reminder to get a sense of what that's like. So if you've missed the podcast over the last few days, I normally put one up every Monday. That's why I've been lying, sweating in a bed somewhere. But I'm back. I'm here. And you probably hear my voice is a little bit rough, but that will help with what we're doing today. It's going to be a resource because we're going to be looking at de-stressing. As this is going to be a de-stressing podcast, please make sure that you're listening to this in a place that's safe for you to do so, because as a result, you might start to feel quite dozy and relaxed. So if you're driving a car, don't listen to it right now, or if you're at work, listen to it at a more appropriate time. You know the drill. You take care of yourself. I thought it would be good to put together some information for you guys to listen to from the previous podcasts to help calm and relax and de-stress. So there's a few things that you may have picked up on in the previous podcasts. First thing is, if you want to de-stress and relax, you need to shift your language into a language which talks about what you want rather than what you've got. So instead of saying, I don't want to be stressed or I want to de-stress, then you need to say, of course, I want to gain calmness and relaxation, because that will encourage the pathways of relaxation and calmness. The second thing, as you can probably notice, and you probably remember from previous podcasts, is to slow your voice down, to lower the tone and the pitch, to make it more like a Western drawl than a fast chipmunk accent. Allow yourself also to be more generous with the pauses in between each word. And as you do that, that encourages a slowing down of the frenetic action of your brain and encourages calmer breathing patterns and relaxation. The next thing I'd suggest we do is that we recognize that when we're really wrapped up in something that is creating stress, then instead we detach ourselves using submodalities. One of the easiest ways to do this is just to step back. In your mind, to step back. Because as you step away from the problem, it allows you to gain perspective and put it at a distance. And I don't know how far that distance will be, whether it will be just a few feet, a few meters, or a few miles away. Putting it over there somewhere, stepping back, allows you to see it anew. Can also help to float above it and far away from it. For those of you who have an in-depth knowledge of NLP, you may recognize this is something that happens in Tad James's timeline therapy and many other approaches as well. But floating above it and a long distance away from it
looking down like you were gazing out of an aeroplane at a town that looks like a tiny, tiny dot from the distance that you're at, again allows us to put it into perspective. Another really cool thing to do is to float into the future far enough that when you look back, you see that it's all resolved. How many times have we found ourselves in the situation where something seemed to be really significant, really important, and really pressing, and that later on in life we can barely remember what it was we were worried about? Another great thing to do is to think about a time when you were in exactly the right state that you needed to be in to resolve problems. Normally this will be a time when you were thinking on your feet, staying calm and focused, being able to be detached, dealing with what was, prioritizing, and just taking things in your stride. Allow yourself to scan your memories to a time where you remember that you feel exactly this way. Something unexpected came and you dealt with it brilliantly. Just recalling this reactivates these very pathways that allow you to access those parts of your brain that are exactly the parts you need to be in touch with. So as you slow your voice down, take yourself back to that time when you feel exactly this calm, resourceful way. And as you do it, notice the things that you can see. Notice the things you're aware of, the sensations, and the sounds you can hear, as that allows you to just take stock calmly and easily. From this place, you can begin to ask yourself, is there anything I need to do now to resolve this that is within my power to do? Often we think we need to do this or that, but actually it's something that we can't do right now. The office may be closed that we need to ring. The people we may need to talk to may not be available. And if that's the case, then we need to change our state to one of serenity and acceptance, knowing that there's nothing we can really do about this right now. Sometimes, of course, there are things we can do. And if that's the case, again, it's a question of asking ourselves, what state would we need to be in to take those actions? Another great question to ask yourself is, what is the first thing I need to do? Very often, people will spend a lot of time generating a whole bunch of solutions and possibilities, which are actually in the distance from where they are right now. There may be one simple thing they need to do, and taking that one step may be all that's necessary to start to move things forwards. You can't take the third and fourth step until you've taken the first and second. So start there, and notice by just doing that, starts to make everything simpler and easier. These are just a few of the tips I've pulled together from all the stuff we've covered in the last 20-something odd podcasts. But you can see, if you've been listening to all the podcasts, the elements you can start to recognize. If you want more of this, then you can get one of my digital downloads from my website, philparker.org, where there's de-stressing, calming CDs, sleeping CDs, all that kind of stuff. So check those out if you're interested.
Essential NLP.